My name is Jeff Haynes. I'm the cross country track swim coach at Lakeside High School in Hot Springs, Arkansas. Started running when I was in the ninth grade. So that's been about 36 years ago. After owning my own business for 13 years and doing rehab for 23 years, sports medicine, I just got tired of going to work every day. And so my wife asked me, what would you do if you weren't doing this? And I said, I always wanted to be a coach. I think every marathoner, the Boston is one of the oldest marathons around. The qualifying standards are pretty tough, but I still qualified. And so in December, I was running a half marathon in Dallas and actually felt a snap in my foot, and I had fractured my calcaneus. And I pretty much had decided that I wasn't going to run Boston, that I would I'd do it again someday. And then started going back to the gym. A friend of mine's dad that came up to my cross trainer said, so when are you going to the Boston? I told him I fractured my foot. I'm not going. And he said, I want you to listen to me. 30 years ago, I qualified for the Boston, and I didn't do it. He goes, I regret it every day that I didn't do it, because that's a once-in-a-lifetime thing. He said, even if you have to walk 26.2 miles, go walk the Boston Marathon, because it's the experience. So I went home, told my wife, we're going to Boston. So with my foot injury, you know, I was running anywhere from 60 to 70 miles a week training up, but my mileage had been cut down to, you know, 20, 25 miles a week. So I knew that my endurance base was not there. And I knew in a marathon, the first 20 miles is easy. The last 6.2 can be hell. But I knew I wasn't going to drop out, because I kept thinking back about my friend's dad that said, I don't care if you have to walk the thing, it's the Boston Marathon. And so that's when you get in your corral, and the excitement is just unbelievable. I mean, you're running the Boston Marathon. Once they fire the gun, you know, it's kind of the first 20 seconds, 30 seconds, you're just standing still, but you just have all the butterflies of, here we go. And so the streets are lined sometimes 2, 3, 4 people deep. And so they're cheering for you the entire way. You want it to be done, but you also know that each mile that you click through, that your experience is almost over. And because of the foot injury, I hadn't been able to train and get the miles that I needed. About the 25-mile mark, I just felt re-energized and started looking around going, man, this is the last mile of the Boston Marathon. You got to start running again. And so I started running again, and I felt like I did in mile one. And so I got right back to pace, and you make that last turn on the finals approach, and the place just erupts. You know, you have no pain. Your foot doesn't hurt. You can't quit smiling. And so you cross the finish line, and they put the medal around your neck, and that's your accomplishment. I stop a guy on the side of the street and ask him if he'd take a picture of me with my medal. And then as you walk up that road, they have all the letters of the alphabet. And so you're looking for your letter, because that's where your family's waiting for you. So I find the H's, and there's my wife and my daughter, and they, you know, we embrace, we hug. And as we're starting to exit the family area, that's when we heard the first explosion.
Breaking news today,
emergency crews rushed to the scene and found spectators piled upon each other, bloodied and injured.
We get to the hotel. There's already armed guards in our hotel. At this point, we still aren't exactly sure what happened at the finish line. So I go in, I turn the TV on, and as we're watching the replay of the bomb, of the explosions, and we see the first one go off, and the clock is right there, and the clock reads 4:08. That was when I asked my wife, I said, babe, what was my time? And she said, 3:52. That's when we realized that, you know, we're 16 minutes and 52 seconds away from being right at ground zero. If I had walked the 25th mile, I could have been right there at the explosion. I often think as I'm coming up that straightaway, I'm high-fiving the little kids right where the bomb went off. The man that I stopped to take my picture, I still to this day think, did I slow him down enough where he wasn't involved, or did I slow him down enough that he was involved? So I still have guilt about that man because I don't know what happened to him. To think that I was that close to being injured and to being possibly killed. To this day, it still hurts. But I don't ever really live in fear. I figure I'm protected, and I don't want people to live in fear. That's why I run with the Bulls. That's why I've gone down a bobsled with the U.S. Olympic team. I just kind of have an adrenaline rush, and I want people to experience what I've experienced. And that's why I coach. That's why when I have people come back and say, hey, I'm running my first marathon, or I want to go do the Boston, I encourage them completely, because I don't want them to live the experience that I lived. But I feel very fortunate that I lived through it. So I just keep encouraging kids to keep running.